Hey, so you're here. Come on, let's fly the kite.
But I don't know how to fly a kite.
You're so silly. It's very easy to fly a kite. This is reel and this is kite. When I ask you to, you must release this thread.
Where is Sugna?
I'm here, Grandma.
Where have you been?
I was with my friend.
I've told you so many times to be in time for the prayers. Do you all see this trunk? I have asked Basant to get it. Now on, the prayer money will be kept in this, not in the plate. Keeping it in the plate is not safe. What if it gets stolen again? After all, it is better to be careful. Times have changed. Even the gods' offerings are no longer safe.
You have not committed any sin. Anandi, now stop crying. Enough, don't cry.
I am not lying.
I know that you would never do this.
Then why does Grandma keep telling that I have stolen the money? I am not a thief. I have asked for God's permission. I had just borrowed the money. Why is no one ready to believe me, Dad?
I believe you, dear. I believe you. I will talk to Mother and tell her. I will convince her that Anandi has not stolen the money.
Even Jagdish had called me a thief.
Is that so? All right. I will talk to him as well. I will ask him, why did he hurt your sentiments? I'll talk to him. All right? Now come with me.
Mm-hmm.
Mother, where's Jagdish?
Must be in his room.
Jagdish? Jagdish, come here.
Coming, Dad.
Be quick.
What is it, Dad?
Jagdish, tell me. Did you call Anandi a thief?
When did I say?
Did you not say that in the kitchen?
I was just kidding.
Kidding? Why would you say that? Would you like someone to call you a thief even if he's kidding?
But Dad, I was just trying
to... Jagdish, if I'm not wrong, then I can clearly remember that you had secretly eaten the God's offering. Will that not be considered a theft? And if it's not, then Anandi is also not a thief.
You made her cry again. Why do you always tease her?
Didn't I say it that I was just kidding? What do I do if she gets serious?
One must never say something for the sake of fun. Come on now, apologize to her.
Sugna! Are you out of your mind like your mother? What are you saying? You will make Jagdish apologize? Have you ever seen a husband apologizing to his wife?
Mother, I don't think it's a big deal if he apologizes. Jagdish won't feel humiliated in his own house.
You just keep quiet, Bhairo. You are out of your mind. You dance to your wife's tunes. Do you want to start a new custom? Sumitra has already embarrassed Jagdish in front of every woman of the neighborhood. Come here, Jagdish. Sit next to me. Yeah. My dear. He's so innocent. But everyone is accusing him.
Leave it, sister. I don't want any apology from Jagdish. I don't want Grandma to get more upset.
Is your drama over now? Now go and do some work.
Hey, silly girl, wait!
Don't be scared. Nothing is going to happen. What is this?
I've got it for Anandi. I didn't have enough money, so I bought less.
Did you see what Jagdish has bought for you? You were scared for no reason.
Take it.
First you call me a thief, and then you give me a gift. I don't want it. You can go and throw it in the well.
Are you still angry? You know I was kidding, right? Why do you take things seriously? Okay, I'm sorry now.
All right. If you insist, your apology is accepted.
I am tired of explaining you, Bhairo. Why do you have to act so stubborn? I don't know when you'll realize. It will be too late by then. Yeah.
Mother, what have I done that you...
Why are you asking me? It hasn't been even a week. That girl ran away and embarrassed the entire family in the village. Have you forgotten? You are supporting her once again. Your wife already does what she wants in the house. Now you are spoiling your daughter and your daughter-in-law as well. This is great, Bhairo. You are great. I salute you. I salute you. I don't know why is it so hard to understand my point. You are just hopeless. I still insist. It is not too late. We still have time. Listen to my advice. I am saying all this based on my experience. A little girl learns things very quickly. She can easily adapt. But if it is too late, then we will be in trouble. You won't be able to control her then. You must not spoil Anandi by giving her too much freedom. After all, she's supposed to take care of Jagdish in future.
Mother, don't you think anyone wants to spoil Anandi? I agree that you are older and experienced. But I'm not a kid either. I'm a father of two kids. Even I have some experience. And my experience tells me that it's not a good idea to be over strict with someone. One must not suppress a person that it smothers that person. Just like...
Just like... Tell me, go ahead. Whom are you talking about? Who has been smothered?
Sumitra. Hasn't she been suppressed her entire life?
What did you say? Say it again. Is your wife being suppressed in this house?
I don't think I'm wrong. I'm telling the truth.
Hello! Mind your language, how dare you insult mom? You're sounding absolutely insane. Can't you even distinguish between the right and the wrong?
I would like to see. What else does this beloved son of mine have in store for me?
I know why you are crying. Just because for the first time I have taken your cause with mother. Sumitra, it took me years to convey the truth. I'm sure you might be thinking that I'm such a crybaby. Everyone knows it was you who have been suppressed from the day you have got married and come to the house. I'm not that stupid not to see your sufferings. It is my fault that I could not stand up against mother at all. But Sumitra, you already know that how I care.
Enough. You don't have to say anything.
I do understand. I know everything. I know that you love me. And that you are helpless. In fact, I don't have any complaints with you. And why should I have any complaint? You are a son before. You are my husband. You have responsibility towards your mother.
Sumitra, I'm also responsible towards you.
So who said that? You didn't fulfill that? You have always been with me. You understand my agony and how I feel. I don't need anything else. Had you not supported me, would have been so difficult to survive. But I'm here just because of you. Can I ask you something?
Sure.
You must apologize to your mother. Though you may have spoken the truth, but you have hurt her sentiments. She is your mother after all. And no one can take her place.
Sumitra, you're so good. I'm so lucky to have you as my wife. I really am so lucky.
Mom Bhairav has gone mad. He must not disrespect his elders. Had it not been you, I would have... No, Mom. He might get more confident day by day. Bhairav must understand this. Whatever he's doing under the influence of his wife is a...
I'm sorry, Mother. I lost my control in anger. It was a very huge mistake to disregard you. This will never happen again. But please forgive me for the last time.
Bhairav, I have never seen a good actor like you. At one moment you are angry. And at the next one you are cool as a cucumber. Do you even realize how much pain have you caused to her? You have disrespected her. Do you think it's so easy to be forgiven? You should have chosen your words wisely. I know everything. I know that you are acting on her directions. Sumitra has asked you to come here, isn't it? You are such a fool. She is telling you everything. Isn't she instigating you against Mom?
Mother, have I ever talked with you like this before? I have always tried that I should never hurt you in any way. But Mother, I can't bear to see Anandi suffering. She has left her family and friends to come and live with us. We are her family now. Though a daughter-in-law, but she is still just a kid. Can't we give her the freedom that we give to our own children? She is just like Sugna. Why can't you try to see from my perspective?
It is difficult. There is a big difference between daughter and daughter-in-law.
There is no difference, mother. There is no difference at all. It is us who have made these customs.
It's not us. It's been followed since many ages. A daughter-in-law can never be a daughter. She can never truly belong to her in-laws. No matter how much you love her, she can never forget her parents.
Have you not done anything for your in-laws, please? Have you never thought of your in-laws' place as your own house in all these years? Do you still prefer your parents' place? Have you not done anything for daddy's family? No, mother. I have seen you worrying about every little thing in this house. You have always tried to improve our finances. How to improve our crop yields? Which fertilizer to use to make our crops better? You have always been worried about these things. Correct me if I'm wrong. I didn't want to disrespect you. But in order to protect my daughter-in-law's pride, I have insulted you. Dad used to tell that you are fortunate for this family. Who else can better understand the plight of a daughter-in-law? Mother, can't you even forgive your son? If not you, then who else is going to understand me? Forgive me, Mother, please. Forgive me.